Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Glory be to the Lamb of God. Hallelujah. Share like and invite, family. Good morning, good morning. Come on, share like and invite. Come on, family. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God bless each and every one of you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is so worthy to be praised. God bless you. God bless each and every one of you. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Hallelujah. I want to give you this morning manna. Hallelujah. I want to give you this morning manna. Hallelujah. Share, like, and invite. Hallelujah. God is so worthy to be praised, family. Hallelujah. God is so worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. I want to speak very briefly what God just spoke to me very clearly. God said he's about to compensate you. Hallelujah. God is getting ready to compensate you. Hallelujah, Jesus. Glory be to the Lamb of God. Somebody ought to be shouting already that God is getting ready to compensate you. Hallelujah. Glory be to the Lamb of God. Hallelujah. Those of you that have your Bible, we'll be coming out of Book of Ruth. Hallelujah. Around the first chapter and the second chapter. Hallelujah. Somebody ought to get excited because God has not forgotten about you. God is getting ready to compensate you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory be to the Lamb of God. Hallelujah. This is Share Like and Invite. Let us know where you're tuning in from this morning. We're getting ready to dive dead into the Word. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Somebody's whole life is getting ready to shift. Hallelujah. 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 You got to learn how to handle, hallelujah, tough times. Glory be to the Lamb of God. Hallelujah. Come on, Miss Betty, where is that she received her compensation? Hallelujah. Anybody know anything about being compensated is for hallelujah. Come on, hallelujah. Send the fire, family. Hallelujah. Anybody know anything about being compensated? That means that you're getting ready to get repaid. Hallelujah. You're getting ready to get paid for what you, hallelujah, had to endure. My God. God did not bring you this far to leave you. We're going to pray very briefly. We're going to go in the Word. I'm going to give y'all this Word. Hallelujah. You can't get out of the will of God because you get in the way of God. Ms. Lee says she already, hallelujah, God has already been compensating me blessings one after another. God bless you. God bless each and every one of you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Send the fire, family. I feel the presence of the Holy Ghost moving and stirring already. God is already moving this morning, family. Hallelujah. Blessings, blessings to each and every one of you. Hallelujah. Welcome to Shine. Unexpected, expect the unexpected live. God can do everything but fail. God is getting ready to compensate you. Hallelujah. God is getting ready to compensate you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's why you couldn't get weary in well doing. That's why you only reap if you faint not. And this message this morning is for the people that God said that did not faint, that did not get weary in well doing. My God, this is for the people this morning that was going to endure this race even until the end. The Spirit of the Lord said that He's getting ready to compensate you for everything that you lost, for every tear that you cried, for every heartache, for every headache. God is getting ready to compensate you for every time they talked about you, for every time they walked away from you, for every time they scandalized your name, for every time they misused you, they abused you. God said, I'm getting ready to compensate. My God. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Listen, send the fire family. Like always, share, like, and invite. Somebody on your timeline needs to hear this. Your timeline is somebody's lifeline. Glory be to the Lamb of God. Get your Bibles. We're in the book of Ruth. Hallelujah. We're in the book of Ruth this morning. The first chapter. Just start right there. Somebody gonna get compensated with a job. Hallelujah. I'm just telling you what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. You understand? Somebody gonna get compensated in their health. Somebody gonna get compensated in prosperity. Somebody gonna get compensated in joy. Somebody gonna get compensated in purpose. Somebody gonna get compensated in happiness. Somebody gonna get compensated. My God, for every tear that you shed, my God, God said it's getting ready to happen. God said it's getting ready to happen. It does not matter what it looked like. God is getting ready to compensate you, hallelujah, when they thought that you were down and out, my God. See, God ain't compensating people that walked away from Him, that was scrawling the fence. God want to compensate some people that stood the test of time. That's why the Bible said the race ain't given to the strong nor the swift, but them that endure unto the end. You might not run as fast as I run. You might not even run. You might crawl. Somebody might walk. Somebody might jump. But as long as you endure until the end, you have experienced loss after loss. Am I talking to anybody this morning? You have experienced loss after loss. And God said, I'm getting ready to compensate for every loss that you had. I'm getting ready to compensate for everything that you lost. I'm getting ready to pay you back. God is giving a divine alignment this morning to align some things to walk dead into your path. Head on is getting ready to happen. Blessings gonna hit you head on. The Bible says that they will run you down and overtake you. You're not gonna be able to miss these blessings that God is getting ready to release upon His people. My God, that's why He said, my sheep know my voice, and a stranger they will not follow. No matter how much doctrine people teach, no matter how many lives they come on, no matter how many churches they build, my sheep know my voice, my God. And when you know the voice of God, glory be to the Lamb of God. The Bible says, even if you did not know God's voice, you will know by the miracle signs and wonders that follow. The Bible says, we'll know a tree by the fruit that it bear. My God, you better start checking the tree for fruit. Glory be to the Lamb of God. Listen, we're going to pray. Get your Bibles. I'm telling y'all better get ready to receive this word. I'm telling you, you're getting ready to get compensated. You understand? You're getting ready. God is getting ready to bring everything back unto you. My God, hallelujah. We're going to pray, and we're going dead into the word. I feel the fire already. My God, I feel the fire already. The presence of God is already in this place. Father, in the name of Jesus, God, we thank you this morning, God, for our late laying down and our early rising this morning. God, we thank you for being God and being God on by yourself. Father, besides you, there is no other. Father, we bless your holy name for your great and you're greatly to be praised. Father, you're Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. And God, we want to tell you thank you for everything you're doing, you did, you have done, and you will do. Father, we thank you for being Jehovah Jireh, God, for being Jehovah Nisi, for being God. My God, Jehovah Shalom, God, we thank you, God, for always being by our side. Father, you said in your word, God, that you would never leave us or forsake us, God. And God, we thank you for being with us even until the end. Father, we thank you, God, that you didn't leave us in the mess that we was in. Father, we thank you for watching over our family and friends as they slumbered and slept last night, God. We thank you, God, for being the God and being the God all by yourself. Besides you, there is no other. Father, we thank you for what you're getting ready to do. God, we thank you for the word that you're getting ready to release through your man servant. Father, we thank you, God, for fresh manna from heaven, God. We thank you, God, for a word to this morning, God. We thank you, God, for being God. My God, my God. We thank you, God, that you did not count it robbery, God, to bless us with a word this morning, God. We thank you, Jesus, for what you did on Calvary. My God, you said if you be lifted up, you'll draw all men. And ever since they lifted you up on Calvary, you drawn all men unto you. My God. Father, we thank you. God, we glorify your holy name, God. God, we even come up against every distraction, God, right now in the name of Jesus, God. Release your fire around this live this morning, God. Speak to your people, Father. Give us this day our daily bread. God, we need a word from you, God, right now, God. Nothing stale, nothing outdated, God, but we need a right now word. Something we going through right now, God. God, bless us this morning, God, with your presence, God. Let them feel the fire as it flows through the live right now in the name of Jesus, God. God, change somebody's situation this morning, God. Right now in the name of Jesus, God. We speak unexpected blessings to show up, God, for your people, God. God, you know right now what we stand in the need of. Father, in the name of Jesus, let me decrease in the natural, increase in the spirit. Father, have your divine way. I'm just a willing vessel, Father. Use me for your glory, God, that you be glorified. And Father, we give you this life. Do what only you came to do this morning. In your son Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory be to the Lamb of God. Listen, is there anybody on the live that you've been faithful, but it's not been fruitful? I'm talking to somebody. Is there anybody? Because the Lord just said some people have been faithful, but it looked like it has not been fruitful. Is that anybody I'm talking to this morning? Is anybody on the line? Because the Spirit of the Lord just dropped on me and said that you've been faithful, but you haven't seen the fruit. These are the people that I want to speak to this morning, that I've been faithful, but my God, I haven't seen the fruit. It's me being faithful, but I don't see the fruitfulness that comes behind being faithfulness. I want to speak to some people this morning to encourage you to hold on, because God is about to compensate you for everything that the devil thought that he stole from you. Do you hear me? I said that the devil thought that he stole from you. The devil cannot take anything. He can only hold it for a second. My God, God is getting ready to give you the house back. My God, God is getting ready to give you the car back. God is getting ready to give you your finances back. God is getting ready to give you your joy back, your peace back, your love back. My God, God is getting ready to give your desire back. Somebody once had a desire to please God, but it looked like your desire had failed by the wayside. God said, I'm getting ready to give you a desire to please me like never before. And God getting ready to give somebody, my God, stability. My God, I heard the Spirit of the Lord say, he getting ready to give somebody stability, because you ain't stable. One minute you here, one minute you there, but you really want to be stable. And God said, I'm getting ready to give you stability. Who am I talking to that will honestly say that it's me that needs stability? It may not be in a housing area, but your finances are not stable. One minute they're up, the next minute they're down. If it's not that, your car is not stable. One minute it's up, one minute it's down. If it's not that, my God, the bills around you are unstable. One minute they're up, next minute they're down. You try to figure out, God, it looked like the more that I get, the more it takes. Somebody on the live this morning, right here, right now, your everything around you is unstable. And every now and then your mind gets unstable. And sometimes you don't even know if you're going or coming, my God. You don't even know what to do, when to do, why to do. You want to serve God, but it looks like the more I try to serve God, the more people pull me unto the world. They start offering me things of the world. The thing that I wanted not to do, they start having parties where I can do them. They start inviting me to stuff that I didn't want to do anymore. I told God for that I'll serve him. But now all of a sudden, as I begin to serve God, people get to pull on me on different angles. I'm speaking to somebody already this morning. I'm speaking firmly to somebody this morning that God said he's getting ready to compensate you. You lost your job based because the devil had people attacking you. But God said, I'm getting ready to give it back. Glory be to the Lamb of God. I'm getting ready to compensate you for the house that you lost. Because you lost it, my God. Because you wanted to stand on the word of God. You refused to lay up, to shack up, to play up. So you lost something standing on the word of God. But God said, because you stood when you could have went back. Because you stood, but when you could have went to the left or to the right. Because you stood, God said, I'm getting ready to show up and show out in your life. I'm getting ready to compensate you. And my God, I see a check, my God. I see a check that's getting ready to blow somebody's mind. Do y'all hear me? Y'all don't hear me this morning. I even see some keys being released in the spirit, but this is not to nothing. Oh, this is something new. My God, my God, my God. You lost a house. You lost a place to stay. My God. And God said, I'm going to compensate because you could have went back and did some strain for a piece of change. You could have went back to your old ways. You could have went back to doing what you wanted to do, when you wanted to do it, how you wanted to do it. God said, because you did not get weary in well-doing, God said, I'm getting ready to compensate you, my God, on a whole nother level. My God, I need somebody to say, God, compensate me. God, compensate me. God, compensate me. God, compensate me. God, compensate me, my God. I didn't do like everybody else. I stood beside you. Even when they persecuted you, I stood beside you. Even when they walked away from you, I stood beside you. Even, my God, my God. See, people will persecute Jesus. You know, they don't really want it. My God. Glory be to the Lamb of God. Somebody getting ready to get compensated. We in the book of Ruth. My God, we in the book of Ruth. I can't even get into it like I want to. I ain't even read it yet. And the Holy Ghost is dropping fresh revelation on me. God, please compensate me, God. God, please, you know, when you get ready to get compensated, you done had enough. You done did all that you know how to do. There's nothing else you can do. You're just sitting waiting patiently, and it looked like that things are going down here for you. But my God, when you get ready to see, to get ready to get this blessing, you get ready to see what God is getting ready to send you, my God, it's going to pay for every rainy day. Hello, somebody. I'm talking to somebody. It's going to pay for every rainy day that you had, for every tear you cry. What God is getting ready to compensate you is getting ready to pay, my God, for every heartache, for every letdown, for every depression, for every recession, for every level of poverty that you went in, for everything that you lost. God said, I'm getting ready to compensate it back unto you. I'm getting ready to give it to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over. God said, I'm getting ready to compensate you, because if it was not, my God, for God on your side, glory be to the Lamb of God. Somebody would have gave up already, but they knew that it was something coming. They didn't know when, and then they didn't know where. But God said, I'm getting ready to compensate you. You understand? See, when a test come up to you, you can't run from it. You can't act according to the test. You got to stand on the word of God. You got to declare the word of God. When it looked like the door is being closed in your faith, you got to stand on the word of God. You got to do what thus said the Lord. My God. And God is getting ready to compensate. Y'all, well, some people waiting on the IRS to cut checks. They already think about what they're going to do with their income tax next. Yeah, but God said, no, I'm getting ready to compensate you now. I'm getting ready to compensate you now. This is nothing that man can do for you. Some money that's being held up, God said, I'm getting ready to compensate you now. Not because of what you did not do, my God. God said, because of what you did do. Glory be to the Lamb of God. Glory be to the Lamb of God. Somebody need to say, I stood. When everybody else ran, I stood the test of time. I stood. Because I knew that there was something greater coming. I knew that there was a day coming. And I knew that there was a reward coming that was greater than me. And I stood the test of time when I could have went back to my old way. When I could have did this. I could have did that. But God, my God, I stood because I know that we serve a miracle working God. And because I stand on his word, the word will not fail me. My God, it will sustain me. My God, I stood. When everybody else left, I stood. And because I stood, my God, God is getting ready to compensate the standards. You understand? God is getting ready to compensate the ones that being planted. God is getting ready to compensate the ones that are not double-minded. God is getting ready to compensate the people that got a well-made up mind that they're going to serve God. My God. Listen, let's get that into the word. I'm telling you, I don't want y'all to think I'm just saying this. You understand? I want you to see what the Lord has showed me this morning. My God, I'm not going to be on here no longer than the Spirit allows. Just give me a few minutes and let me work this word. You understand? Ruth chapter 1. Hallelujah. Now it came to pass in the days when the judge ruled, and there was a famine in the land, and a certain man of Beth of Judah went to sojourn in the country of Moab, him and his wife and his two sons. And the name of the man was Amich, and the name of his wife was Naomi. My God. And he had two sons, Mahlon and Chilion. Verse number, we're going to go skip down right quick. Verse number 3. And Amich, Naomi's husband, he died. And she was left, her and her two sons. And they took them wives of the women of Moab. The name of one was Oprah, and the name of the other was Ruth. And they dwelt there about 10 years, and both of the sons died. Do you hear me? They dwelt there 10 years, and they lost the daddy first. And they dwelt there 10 more years, and they lost two of the sons. Now, I need y'all to catch this in the Holy Ghost. The man is known as the head, my God. The man is known as the head. So if you look at it in the realm of the spirit, they lost the head. My God, they lost the head. My God, the men was the provider, the men was the way maker, and that's somebody on here right now. You are doing it all by yourself. This is a woman that I'm talking to. You are doing it all by yourself. There is no man in the household. There is no man that in the natural that is helping you out. It's only you and God. Is there any woman on here right now? You standing the test of time, but it looked like I lost this and then I lost that. And it looked like it was a loss after a loss. Naomi lost three back to back. She lost her husband, then she lost her two sons. And then Oprah and Ruth, they lost three. They lost their father-in-law, and they lost their husband and their brother-in-law. My God, they lost. It was a loss after a loss. My God. Let's skip over. Hallelujah. Verse 7, therefore she went forth out of the place where she was, her and her two daughter-in-laws with her. And they went on their way to return unto the land of Judah. And Naomi said unto her two daughter-in-laws, go return each to her mother's house. The Lord dealt kindly with you as you have dealt with the dead and with me. The Lord grant you that you may find rest, each of you, in the house of her husband. Then she kissed them, and they lifted up their voices, and they wept. 11. And Naomi said, turn again, my daughter. Why will ye go with me? Are there not any more sons in my womb that I may behold your husband? She said, listen, is there any more? I done gave you, out of the two sons that God gave me, y'all married them and they're dead. Even if you stay with me, see, this is the problem what a lot of people have. They don't want to stay with God in tough times. I need somebody to say, stay with God in tough times. Stay with God in tough times. Because tough times, they bring forth compensation. Sooner or later, the tough times that you're facing will bring forth compensation, my God. Stay with God in tough times. Stay with him. Stay with him. Naomi had experienced a tough time. She had lost her husband. She lost her two sons. And now she was telling her daughter-in-law, she said, listen, y'all go on back to your family's house. Y'all, I pray everything go well with you. I pray everything is good with you. But Oprah, she said, okay, I'm gonna go ahead on and go. I'm gonna go on back to my family house. I'm gonna go back where it's comfortable at, because you don't have anything. The men's are not here to provide anymore. I'm gonna go ahead and go back. But Ruth said, no, I'm not going back. I'm not going back to where I came from. Somebody this morning need to say, I'm not going back where I came from. Somebody on the line this morning need to say, I'm not going back to where I came from. My God. I feel the power of the Holy Ghost. There's a fire stirring up, my God. God is getting ready to compensate you. You better hold on to God's unchanging hand. My God. Ooh, Jesus. Y'all don't understand. Y'all don't understand. Y'all don't understand. Naomi said, y'all go back. I don't have anything left to give. God, nothing. I'm not giving nothing. I don't have nothing. My husband is gone. I lost my two sons. I don't have anything left to give to you. But old Oprah, she said, you know what? I'm going to go back. You understand where I came from. And some of you was on the verge of going back to where you came from. But I want to encourage you, if you go back to where you came from, there will be no more story. There will be no glory in going back. Glory be to the Lamb of God. The Bible declares that Oprah went back, but the Bible mentions nothing else about Oprah, my God, because it's over. It's done with. When you go back unto your mess, the Bible declares in Proverbs 26:11 that even a dog will return back to his vomit. Is somebody on here? You were thinking about going back unto your old ways, but I want to encourage you, you better not go back, because if you go back, you're going to get lost in the back. The devil wants you to go back. But Naomi said, listen, y'all can go back. God said, it's your will. If you want to stay, stay. If you want to go, go. But God said, listen, for the ones that go back, God said, we don't hear nothing else about them in the Bible. No more in the Bible do we even, the Bible even speaks of this woman, Oprah, anymore. But Ruth said, no, I'm not leaving you. And some of you need to tell God, God, it may be tough, but I'm not leaving you. God, it may be tough, but I'm not leaving your side. I may be going through left and right and right and left, but God, I'm not leaving you. I'm not leaving your side, because one thing, you never forsake me, and I'm not getting ready to forsake you. I'm not going back. I'm not going back to my ways. I'm not going back into bondage. I'm not going back into fornication. I'm not going back into adultery. I'm not going back into homemonger. I'm not going back into drinking. I'm not going back into cussing. I'm not going back into lying. I'm not going back into backbite. I'm not going back until what God has pulled me out of. Just because we experience a little tough time, do you understand there's a price to pay to fly high? People will walk away from you when you're flying high. People will walk away from you when you're flying high. Let me tell you something. When a plane takes off, the plane, when it gets to a certain altitude, it begins to experience turbulence. It gets a little shaky. And so many people, when they feel that shakiness, they want to go back. But I want to encourage you to buckle up, baby, and watch God take you higher and watch everything level out. Because so many people, they don't want to go through to get to. God, I'm not going back. Now, I need y'all to listen to this. Verse number 14, and they lifted up their voice and wept again. And Oprah kissed her mother-in-law, but Ruth clave unto her. Oprah kissed her and says, so long, see ya, I gotta go. And I want to encourage somebody that there the world is calling you back. They calling you back into the world. They calling you back. And you don't have to go back. You can walk away if you want to. God ain't going to make you stay with him. But my God, you only get paid when you stay. God only paid you when you stay. God ain't paying nobody to go back into the mess that he just pulled you out of. Verse number 16. Now 15, I'm going to read 15. And she said, behold, thy sister-in-law goes back unto her people. Do y'all hear this? Her sister-in-law, Oprah, Ruth's sister-in-law, went back to her people. What is that saying? You went back unto the place you was most comfortable at because it was some hard time, because you didn't understand everything. You went back to what you thought that you knew. Glory be to the Lamb of God. You went back because you feel like it was good. You weren't going to make it right here, right now. You went back because it looked like people were talking about you. You went back because they were talking about people that you was around. You went back unto your mess. My God, you got to watch, God. I'm not going back. I'm not going back. I don't care if my family go back. I don't care if my friends go back. I don't care if my enemies stay back. I'm not going back. I'm not going back. I'm not going back. If you are not going back, you need to declare, I am not going back. I am not going back. I am not going back. Some of you need to just justify to yourself. You need to clear this thing up within yourself, because what is happening is you having a whole conversation in your own mind, within your own self, talking about, well, I should, I would, I might, I don't know, this, that. You scrap, my God, you stuck between opinions. You're stuck between opinions. Come on, I'm getting ready to work this word, family. I'm not going back. I'm not going back from where God brought me out of. God brought me out of a gang. I'm not going back into a gang. God brought me out of selling drugs. I'm not going back to sell drugs. God brought me out of homosexuality. I'm not going back. And until you realize that there's nothing in the back that you need to go back for. There's nothing back there that means you any good. But one thing that Ruth told Naomi told Ruth and Oprah, she said, listen, y'all can go back. Ruth said, I ain't going nowhere. Oprah said, let me kiss you and let me be on my way. Because everybody ain't going to stand the test of time. I'm not going back. 16, and Ruth said, entreat me not to leave thee or return from falling after thee. For wherever thou goest, I will go. Ruth said, listen, wherever you go, God, I'll go. Wherever you lead me, I'll go. Whatever you call me to do, I'll do. Because Ruth is sold out to being faithful. And some of you on the line need to sell out to be faithful to God, because you can't get compensated from God if you ain't faithful to God. I spoke a word then. You cannot get compensated from God if you're not faithful to God. What am I saying? They don't compensate you for a wreck that you was not in, for the time at work you did not lose. They don't compensate you for something that did not happen to you. I'm not going back. It does not matter what it looks like. I myself am not going back. People around you may go back, but you don't need to go back. You understand, your blessing is in front of you and not behind you. That's why when you get in the car, the rearview mirror is smaller than the windshield, because you don't need to know much about where you came from. You need to know where you're going to. My God. So she said, wherever you go, Ruth said, Naomi, wherever you go, I'll go with you. And some of you need to tell God, wherever you lead, I'll follow. The Bible says a good man's steps are ordered by the Lord. God, wherever you lead me, I'll go. Because God is getting ready to lead you into compensation. God ain't leading you into no dry place. God ain't leading you into a place, my God, where it's going to hurt you. God leading to you into a place of compensation. And where God leads you, yeah, it's some people that can't go. It's some people that going to walk away from you when you say, I'm going to serve God. It's some people that going to talk about you when you say, I'm going to serve God. But one thing God desire is somebody that's going to stand for God regardless of what's going on around them. I will stand. I will stand. So they went, verse number 19. So they went until they came unto Bethlehem. And it came to pass when they were coming to Bethlehem that all the city was moved about them. And they said, is this Naomi? And she said unto them, call me not Naomi, call me Mara. For the Almighty have dealt very bitterly with me. I went out full, and the Lord have brought me home again empty. I know it don't look right for you to leave out one way and come back a totally different way, but God likes to empty you out so he can refill you. Somebody need to tell God, refill me, refill me, refill me, because I'm empty. I'm out of money. I'm out of options. My God, I'm out of ways. Refill me, God. Refill me, God. Refill me. So Naomi returned, and Ruth the Moabitess, her daughter-in-law, with her, which returned out of the country of Moab, and they came unto Bethel and began the beginning of barley harvest. Chapter 2. And Naomi had a kinsman of her husband, a mighty man of wealth, of the family of Amich, and his name was Boaz. And Ruth the Moabitess said unto Naomi, let me now go to the field and glean ears of corn after him, whose sight I shall find grace. And she said unto her, go, my daughter. What am I saying? I'm saying somebody trying to go back to a place that God ain't told you to go back to. You trying to go back unto your old way. You trying to go back unto your old habits. But there is nothing there that will refill you. You understand? Because that place cannot sustain you. What God brought you out of, the devil want to draw you back into. Let me say that again. What God brought you out of, the devil want to draw you back unto. It is not by coincidence that the devil, my God, is only using stuff, my God, that you are familiar with. The devil ain't gonna tempt you with something that you're not familiar with. The devil gonna tempt you with something that you're familiar with, something that you like. And until you make up your mind that I'm not going back, and God refill me right where I'm at. I may be low on gas, but God refill me before I go back and try to get something from a place that I came from, that God delivered me from. God refill me right here, side the road. God refill me. I don't want to be the same. And you got people that are in their 40s and 50s and 60s, they still partying, and you understand, and carrying on. They still living their life, and they doing things any kind of way. And they think, man, my God, and they think that this is living the life, but you ain't lived the life until you lived it for Christ. My God, I said something there. Thank you, Holy Ghost. You have not lived this life until you live for Christ. Now, verse number 2. And Ruth the Moabite said unto Naomi, she won't let me go into the field because we don't have nothing. Yes, yeah. It be times that you're with God and it look like you ain't got nothing. Can anybody attest to that? It was time that looked like everybody around me, they were growing and glowing. It looked like I didn't have anything. Naomi and Ruth went back with Naomi to Naomi's husband. Not Naomi's land, Naomi's husband land. My God. She went back to her husband land. And Ruth went with her. And Ruth said, I won't leave you. God, wherever you lead me, I'll go. I'll do what you called me to do. See, one thing Ruth knew was that Naomi had been faithful to Ruth. Isn't this strange that God has been faithful to you 30, 40, 50, 60, 70 years? God has been faithful to you 10 years, 20 years, in your teens, in your 20s, in your 30s, in your 40s, in your 50s, in your 60s, in your 70s. God has been faithful to you. Now it's time for you to be faithful to God. I want to know, will you be faithful to God as God has been faithful to you? Will you be as faithful to God as God has been faithful to you? I don't know if you're willing to do it or not, but I would encourage somebody, you ought to be doing that. Because even in the midst of your mess, God kept you. Even in the midst of adversity, God kept you. Even when you thought you was losing your mind, God kept you. So I want to encourage somebody that you ought to be as faithful to God as God was faithful to you. In that wreck, God spared you. My God, when you lost your house, God kept you. In the midst of that fire, God was there. When people walked away, God was still there. God didn't leave you. You might have left God, but God didn't leave you. Now watch this. Watch this. He said that after him whose sight I shall find grace. And she said unto her, go, my daughter. And she went out and came and gleaned in the field after the reapers, and her house was to light on the part of the field belonging to Boaz, who was the kindred of Amish. She said, listen, Ruth said, listen, Naomi, you looked out for me. And see, this is the problem that the Lord is having with some saints, is that he look out for you, but you ain't looking out for him. You're not willing to stand up even when it's not popular. You're not willing to stand when everybody offering you drinks and partying. You're not willing to stand and say, nah, for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. It ain't no party like the Holy Ghost party, because the Holy Ghost party don't stop. All the other parties, they stop. They get you locked up. You get in jail. You get fights broke out. All of this stuff, you in a mess. But people don't want to talk about what's real because so many people are doing it. But then it ain't popular when somebody dying in these places. It ain't popular then when somebody lose their life. It ain't popular then. But the Bible say, the day you hear my voice, harden not your heart. In Hebrews, it says, the day you hear my voice, harden not your heart. And there's so many people, they stuck. They only want God to deliver their children. They only want God to deliver their family. They only want God to deliver them. And once God delivered them, they go back into the very thing that God delivered them out of. God delivered them from drinking, they go back to drinking. God delivered them from smoking dope, they go back to smoking dope. God delivered them from heroin and crack cocaine and homemonging and back. They go back to it. They do what Oprah did. Oprah left Naomi when Naomi had nothing to give. When it looked like Naomi had nothing left in her to give, Oprah left. Ruth said, I'm staying. Because I know how good God has been. And some of you got to stay because you know how good God has been. You got to stay because God has been too good to you. Let's go further. Verse 4. And behold, Boaz came from Bethlehem and said unto the reapers, the Lord be with you. And they said, answered him, they said, the Lord bless thee. And then Boaz said unto his servants that who was set over the reapers, who is this damsel is this? Who this servant that was set over the reapers answered and said, it is a Moabitess damsel that came back with Naomi out of the country of Moab. And she said, I pray you, let me glean and gather after the reapers among the sheaves. So she came and have continually, even from morning until now, that she tarried a little in the house. By God. She said, listen. She said, listen. We got to quit making excuses. We got to make it happen. You understand? Because see, the devil let you make excuses, but God ain't tolerate no excuse. You understand? Look, she said, Naomi could have said, you know, I'm going to stay here and die. And Ruth could have said, I'm going to stay here and watch you. Or Ruth said, I ain't going to die with you. But get what Ruth said. Ruth said, I'm fit to go out and glean. You done worked all these years. Now I'm fit to work for you. Come on. Come on. Hebrews 13:3. He said, listen, I done worked all these years. And Naomi has worked them years. And she was there for Ruth all that time. Ruth did not leave her because she did not have anything to offer. A lot of people, because God ain't steady blessing you with stuff that you can see in your hand. Because God ain't blessing you with stuff that you can see in your hand, they'll make an excuse to leave God. They're making an excuse to leave, like, well, I don't see nothing else happening. This place dried up. No, that place ain't dried up. God just want to see who is who. God will let you know who's for you and who's against you, because everybody will walk with you when you're sitting on the top. But very few, do y'all hear me? Very few will stay with you when it don't look like that you're reaching the top. A lot of people want to be with you just for association. So many people want to be with you just to say, I know him, and because I know him or I know her, it makes me feel like I'm somebody. No, everybody got to be somebody in God, they self. Naomi could have said, listen, Ruth, don't go and glean for me. It's over for me. But Ruth said, Naomi, I'm going to do for you what you done for me. I'm finna go out and work and provide. And Ruth did exactly that. Now, here is the thing why I said God is getting ready to compensate you. Pay attention. When Boaz came to the field, Boaz was over the field. When Boaz came, see, Ruth could have said, well, you know what? It's too hot out there for me. I'm too pretty to go outside and pick corn and glean. I'm not used to that. My husband used to doing everything. I'm not used to working. I'm not used to doing this. I'm not used to doing that. I'm not used to going without getting my nails done. I'm not used to not getting my hair done. I'm not used to not buying new clothes and shoes. Ruth said, listen, you done did it for me. I'm fit to do it for you. And some of you need to be as faithful to God as God has been faithful to you. See, the problem is the devil let us make excuses while God sent back. Jesus could not even make an excuse to take him off of the cross. He said in the Garden of Gethsemane, he said, Father, not my will, but thy will be done in my life. I give up my will for your will. And people don't want to do that. You understand? Because people want to rather make an excuse instead of make something happen. You understand? Because an excuse is easily made. You know, when you go to school, you be like, oh, I ain't do my homework. Oh, the dog ate it. Oh, I left it at home. Oh, it rained and water all over it. Oh, I forgot it. It's on my bed. Knowing good and well that that's just an excuse that you're making. God ain't tolerating no excuse. I'm here to tell y'all. I'm telling you, Jesus died on the cross. He gave up his life. There was no excuse. When you get to heaven, there will be no excuse. God, I was trying to do this and I was trying to do that. No, it ain't no such thing. Because he said, if you take one step, I'll take two. And a lot of people, they are making excuses before they make a step. I need somebody to put that down. Stop making excuses, make steps. Stop making excuses, make steps. Stop making excuses, make steps. Because the Bible says a good man's steps are ordered by the Lord. Stop making excuses, make steps. It ain't that you can't live right, you just don't want to live right. I'm just being honest. It ain't about the viewers. It ain't about the people who follow me. God only looking for the people that really want him. That's why he said, those that will, let them come. You know, we can't use this thing. Ain't nobody perfect. Nobody asking you to be perfect. We just, God is asking you to live holy. Holy. Holy is a lifestyle. Come on. Don't make excuses. Make steps. For every excuse that you made, if you would have made a step, you would be farther down the road by now. But this is the part where you lose people. Because they don't really want God. They want you to preach some doctrine that gonna make them feel good. I'm not no feel good man. I'm not trying to make people feel good in sin. Do you know that the wages of sin is death? I can't make you feel good when you will die and go to hell in sin. That is not God, my God. If you want a watered down sermon, you might have to preach it. I'm telling you, any of my team that's with me, I don't let up off of them. I don't let up off of them. You understand? Because I didn't get where I'm at for making excuses. I used to smoke. I used to party. I didn't make excuses. God, I'm trying. God, I'm trying. No. When you want to give everything up, come on. Many are called, but only few are chosen. When you want to give everything up, when you walk away from everything, that's when God walk up to you. But a lot of people are not walking away from it. That's why they still got their hands on it. That's why the excuse come into play. Because your body and your flesh still want to do what you want to do and hold on to God. But you can't walk with God and run with the devil. No, you can't do it. You can't do it. I don't care who tell you you can. I don't care what message they pray about grace. They tell you one thing about grace, but here's the thing that people won't tell you. It's a thing called grace and truth. Watch this now. It's a thing called grace and truth. Anytime Jesus ran into somebody and he healed them and he delivered them out of their situation, here is the grace. He said, I forgive you. That's the grace. But here is the truth that came behind it. He said, go and do it no more. Go and sin no more. That was the truth. You can preach grace till you're blue in the face, but you better preach truth behind it, because once he forgave you, you ought to not go back and do it again. I forgive you. go and sin no more. Watch this now. See, people don't understand it. You understand? Because they want the watered down messages. They want the sugar coat. Man, let me just bring this up here, because this woman of God said something then. Sugarcoating is deadly. Too much sugar, you have a sugar attack. I don't give you sugar. That's the problem. You got so many preachers, and they do what they want to do because that blood on their hands. A lot of people standing in there, they preaching the sugar watered down message and telling, giving it to you straight, because the word going to do one or two things. Going to draw you or drive you. And because I said about the club, everybody didn't like it. Because I said about drinking, everybody didn't like it. Because I said about making excuses, everybody didn't like it. So what? You might not like it. But one thing about it, I will not die and go to hell because I did not tell you the truth. Here is the truth. The wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. Here is your grace. Whatever you have done, he forgive you. But here is the truth. He said, go and sin no more. Now watch this. Hallelujah. Verse 8. Verse 7. She said, I pray you let me glean, gather after the reapers among the sheaves. So she came and have continued even from the morning and even until now that she tarried a little in the house. Watch this. Verse 8. Then said Boaz unto Ruth, hear thou not, my daughter. Go not unto glean unto another field. This is why I'm telling you, you ain't got to go into no another field. You ain't got to go into no another place. You ain't got to go nowhere else. God will bless you right where you at. He said, if you be faithful over a few things, God get ready to make you ruler over many. That's why I come to tell somebody, God get ready to compensate you for every time they talked about you, for every time they walked away from you. Do you know every time somebody walk away from me, God sent me 10 more. My God, there's a 10 that's coming to you for everybody that talked about you, for everybody that walked away from you. God is getting ready to bless you. Why? Because you stood the test of time. And a lot of people don't want to stand the test of time because they want to please the flesh. You cannot please the flesh and please God. Jesus said it like this: deny yourself. What is yourself? Deny that flesh and follow me. Take up thy cross and follow me. Jesus had to deny his flesh when he said, Lord, please let this bitter cup pass from me. He said, but you know what? Nevertheless, not my will, but thy will be done in my life. He said, you know what? I don't care what this flesh say. I don't care about the flesh anymore. I want to please God. And so many people are dying by the wayside, but we still partying, we still drinking, we still home mugging, we still backbiting, we still doing what we want to do. But we ain't looking at the signs and the time. We ain't looking at that because we want a watered down message. What is the purpose of going to church and going to hell? I didn't come this far because I didn't have to give up nothing. Anybody, any preacher, anybody walking in the anointing, the power that has the fire of God, whatever the case may be, they had to give up something. God calls it for people to give up something to follow him. You got to give up your will for his will. People say, God, he can give you the desires of your heart, right? No, he ain't going to give you the desires of your heart until your heart become his heart. Then he'll bless you with it. My God, watch this, family, we almost done. We almost done because we make more excuses than we make stuff happen. If you stop making excuses and start making steps, then you'll see the hands of God move in your life. No, I'm not trying to beat you across the head, but guess what? If you leave out of here today and go out there and die in sin, you ain't going to be raised up in no glory. Let's be honest about it. But the devil will tell you, you can do what you want to do. You got time to get it together. But if you got time to get it together, then do what you want to do. But the last I checked, the Bible said, no man know the day nor the hour that the Son of God return. Somebody need to hear what the Spirit is saying to the church, because somebody on here might not be here the next time we go live. Somebody in your family might not be here the next time we go live. You understand? The truth hurt, my God. The word hurt. When you give them the truth, Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. When you give them the truth hurt. The truth does not feel good when you want to stay in it. You got to give up every way of the world to follow God. God ain't following you. Jesus said, pick up your cross and follow me. He ain't falling behind you. You got to fall behind him. He know the way. We serve an omnipotent God, an all-knowing God. Stop making excuses and start making steps. Verse number 9, let thy eyes be on the field that thou do reap, and go thou after them. I have not charged the young men that they shall not touch thee. And when thou art thirst, go into the vessel and drink of that which the young men had drawn. Now listen to this. Y'all got to understand. Listen to this. Now what he's saying is, he said, listen, Boaz looked at Ruth and said, because you did not give up, because you did not leave Naomi's side. This is what God is saying to some of y'all. Because you did not leave my side, I'm getting ready to compensate you. I'm getting ready to compensate you. You've been experiencing little blessings right now. You know what I'm saying? You've been able to glean. You've been able to work and get the money you need to make it, you know, make ends meet. And you understand, you've been able to get that, and now you're getting a little water. You're getting a little bit extra. My God. Now, verse number 10. Then she fell on her face and bowed herself to the ground and said unto him, why have I found grace in thy eyes that thou shalt take knowledge of me, seeing I'm a stranger? Why have I found grace in your sight, seeing I'm a stranger? He said, the only reason you're finding grace in the sight of God is because when everybody else walked away and wanted to do what they want to do, you served me. You stood on my word. And because you did not leave, my God, because you did not leave God's side, no matter what the world had to offer, God said, I'm getting ready to compensate you. Watch this, family. We getting ready. We almost there. People don't want to hear. People want to hear about compensation, but they don't want to hear about the price that you have to pay to be compensated. When people are involved in a wreck and they miss time at work, the insurance company is supposed to compensate them. They lost something. And some of you, if you're not willing to lose sin, my God, if you're not willing to lose sin, if you're not willing to drop sin, you can't be compensated for something that you did not lose. Verse 11, and Boaz answered and said unto her, it hath fully been shown me all that thou have done unto thy mother-in-law since the death of thy husband. God said, it has been shown. Your praise, your prayers, your walking has been brought up to him as a memorial. Your living has not been in vain. Ever since the death of your flesh, ever since you let the flesh die, ever since you stopped doing what you want to do, ever since you quit doing what you want to do, God said, it's been brought up to me, and now I got to compensate you, because you could have went back in the flesh, but because you denied the flesh, God is getting ready to compensate you for everything that you denied, my God. Now thou have left thy father and thy mother in the land of thy native, and art coming to a people which thou knewest not, my God. Here 2 of 4. Miss Lou, you on? Hallelujah. Glory be to the Lamb of God. There's a word of the Lord. Verse 12. The Lord recompensated thy work. Now, recompensate means compensate. That means he repaid. Hello, somebody. That means he repaid. That means he repaid. Let me show you. That means he repaid. Glory be to the Lamb of God. That means God said, listen, that the Lord recompensated thy work. And a full reward, listen to me, a full reward be given unto thee of the Lord God of Israel. God bless you. A full reward was given unto thee. This is your part right here, Miss Lou. The Lord recompensated thy work. My God. You need to catch that in the Holy Ghost. That means God repaid you for the work that you do for him. The Lord said, prepare yourself, because I'm recompensating you for what you've done for me. You better receive that in Jesus' name. You better receive that in Jesus' name. That, under whose wings thou art come to trust. Then she said, let me find favor in thy sight, my Lord, that thou have comforted me, and thou hast spoken friendly unto thy handmaid, though I be not like unto one of thy handmaids. My God. My God. My God. My God. Listen. Boaz said, your work has been brought up to God as a memorial. See, what he's telling you, Lou, is the stuff you did behind the scenes for other people. He said, I'm getting ready to repay. You better receive that in Jesus' name. I'm getting ready to repay. Some of you, you could have lost your life, but he spared it. That way you owe God your whole life. And the problem is we don't want to give God what's due to God. Watch this now. Ruth asked Boaz, how do I find this favor in your sight? He said, because God is getting ready to repay you for everything that you lost. I'm speaking to somebody already. God is getting ready to repay you for your faithfulness. Some of you need to receive this right now. God is getting ready to compensate you for the, my God, for you, your body was attacked with an illness, but God is getting ready to compensate you with health. Some of you, God is getting ready to compensate you. You was in poverty, but God is getting ready to compensate you with prosperity. Some of you was in weeping, but God is getting ready to compensate you in joy. Some of you was in pain, but God is getting ready to compensate you with purpose. Some of you have about to lose a house, but God is getting ready to compensate you with overflow. Some of you didn't have enough, but God is getting ready to compensate you with more than enough. Some of you were compensated, my God, you had loneliness, but God is getting ready to compensate you, my God, with happiness. Some of you are getting ready to get paid back for what you've done for somebody else. The Bible says that the affirmative prayers of the righteous availeth much. If you lost a house, God said, I'm going to compensate you for it. If you lost a car, I'm going to compensate you for it. Now, Lou, I see another car. I don't know, but God, the Spirit of the Lord has showed me a vehicle. So prepare yourself. But there's a vehicle that God is getting ready to open a door for you. Hallelujah. There is a vehicle that God is getting ready to open a door for you. Some of you, you had more bills than money, and God said, because you didn't get weary and well doing, because you, even though you didn't have, you barely had enough to make it, you still stood on my word. You did not complain. And God said, I'm getting ready to repay you for every tear that you shed. I'm getting ready to give you back for everything that you lost, everything the devil stole from you. God said, I'm getting ready to repay you. I'm getting ready to repay you the years that the locust and the cankerworm ate up. God said, I'm getting ready. Even the pomegranate. God said, I'm getting ready to compensate you. I'm getting ready to pay you back. My God. Listen here. It's about three people or more on here that if you go back and look at your life, you shouldn't even be here by now because of an accident. If that's you, say it's me. It's three people. It's at least three people on here that you know it was nobody but God that spared you in your accident. If that's you, say it's me. Watch this, family. Glory be to the Lamb of God. If that's you, say it's me. One. It's at least three people. We got three, y'all. Look at that, four. Come on. Didn't I tell you it was at least three? I'm going to speak prophetically to these people. While they're playing me, some of you, God said, you're getting ready to stumble into the biggest blessing that you have ever seen in your life. Six, seven. We're at seven now. I'm talking about these people. I are not even supposed to be here today. We had seven right now. And I'm getting ready to speak to them prophetically. I'm getting ready to speak to us prophetically. Anymore. Hey, anymore. Hallelujah. If that's you tonight, we need you to come on in and say it's me. Because God is getting ready. Hallelujah. You got that right. Nothing but the blood of Jesus that covered. 9, 10. Watch this, family. Y'all getting ready to see. Y'all getting ready to see. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Anymore, we getting ready to. You know that accident should have took you out. But God spared you. God spared you. When you couldn't spare yourself, God spared you. 11. 11 people so far on here. Don't even supposed to be here right now. 11. 11. 11. 11. 11. 11. 11. Hallelujah. Listen, for the people that miss death. Death came for you, but God stood in the gap. He had an angel on assignment to cover you. The enemy wanted to take you out, but God. God said, I would not allow that to happen. Because there's a call upon your life. And the enemy want to close your mouth to ministry. So the enemy wanted to kill you prematurely. But God had an angel on assignment that when you was involved in this accident, that, my God, that what should have killed you, God said, I preserved you. And now that I preserved you, I need you to live for me wholeheartedly. God said, there's a testimony on the inside of each of these people. And it ain't got nothing just to do with no accident. It's a testimony that they got inside. They ain't let it out yet. God said, I preserve you for a time such as this. And God said, you saw your light flash before your eyes. But when you came to, you made it through. You ought to tell God thank you for the angels that he got dispatched on assignment around you. The devil thought he had you, but God came and grabbed you. There's the blood of Jesus covering these people. And yeah, life is hard for you right now. These people that I'm talking to, the Lord said that life is hard right now. But God said, I'm getting ready to compensate. If you can be steadfast, unmovable, I'm getting ready to compensate you. For every pain that you went through, I'm getting ready to compensate you. My God, listen. Sheena, please. With everything inside of you, Sheena, please. Sheena, please. Please. The Lord says, seek him while he may be found. Sheena, please. Please don't return back, please. Truth of the matter, Sheena, the devil has people on assignment to take you out. Y'all send the fire family. We got to cover Sheena. Sheena, please. You was not supposed to make it. But it wasn't by might nor by power. God said it because of what I got inside of you. But God said when you submit your will to my will, you understand the purpose of your life. Sheena, you don't even understand, my God. Y'all, the Holy Ghost speaking. Sheena, you don't even understand the purpose of your life. I even see sometimes you ask God, why am I here anyway? I feel like I'm the black sheep. I feel like I'm the sole thumb. I feel like the world would be a better place without me. Sheena, I'm asking you to surrender wholeheartedly to God. You not only had one death experience, watch this, but you have had more than one. Sheena, is this true? The Spirit of the Lord said it wasn't just that accident. But you have had more than one death experience. Sheena, is this true? Yes or no? Send the fire, family. Come on, talk to me, Sheena. Come on. Whoa. My God, send the fire, family, send the fire. Water is even running down her face right now. I see her in the realms of the spirit. If I was on the other live, I would bring her on and y'all would see. Water is running down her eyes because she know that it wasn't just one experience with death that she had. Cover her, Jesus. Sheena, a tree just planted is easily moved. Stay in the presence of God, Sheena. You got to stay covered because the enemy came to steal, kill, and destroy. And because, my God, you have experienced more than one time the enemy tried to kill you, God said, I covered you. God said, I covered you, Sheena. Time and time again, you come to me and then you go back when everything is fine. Sheena, seek him. We cover you under the blood of Jesus. And the thoughts of suicide that have crossed your mind, we curse it at the root in the name of Jesus. And we send the fire of God to afflict everything that's been afflicting you and even some health issues. My God. My God, even some health issues. Heal her, Jesus. Heal her, Jesus. Heal her now in the name of Jesus. The longer you stay away from God, the the more the spider web wraps you up, and the harder it is for you to come back to God. It looks like every time you make up your mind to serve God, it looks like you get attacked the worst. It looks like everything come up against you. But God said, when it come, because a tree just planted is easily moved, when they come up against you, stand still and you will see the salvation of God. Sheena, the devil got a plot, but God got a plan for your life. You got to determine which you gonna fall. Every person that was on here, we had 11 people on here that the Lord released and said that you almost died in an accident. And the angel of the Lord showed up. And when you go back and look at the accident and look at the pictures and the scene and where you was at, you can't even believe it yourself. But somehow I made it through. God said it wasn't by might nor by power, by his spirit, said the Lord. You ought to turn your life completely over to Jesus and say, for God I live and for God I die. God, you didn't have to spare me, but you did. And because you did spare me, I gotta live for you. Some of you getting ready to walk into your blessing. Some of you getting ready to stumble into your blessing. Some of you getting ready to be compensated for everything that you went through. God said, I'm getting ready to compensate you for every person that talked about you. God said, I'm getting ready to compensate you for every tear you cried on the side of your bed, for every tear you shed it in the car, for every tear you shed it in the bathroom, for every tear you shed it inside. God said, I'm getting ready to compensate you for the tears you shed, for weeping may endure for a night, but God said, prepare yourself, for joy is getting ready to come in the morning, and you getting ready to experience the hands of God move upon your life like never before. You ought to tell God, God, I thank you for what you're getting ready to do in my life. God, I thank you. If it had not been, Sheena, for the Lord on your side, truth be told, Sheena, you wouldn't even be here. But God is protecting what's, my God. God is protecting the gift inside of you. And I heard the Spirit of the Lord say, protect what's protecting you. You got to protect the gift on the inside of you. You got to stand up and declare the works of the Lord. You can't even live your way no more. No more. No more the question marks on your head. Lord, why? Come unto me. Some of you are getting ready to experience a compensation in health. Your health had failed you, but God said, I'm sending total healing. God said, I'm sending total healing. Some of you men have let you down. You put all your trust in a man or a woman and they let you down and they failed you. But God said, I'll never leave you or forsake you. I'll be with you to the end. And because man failed you, God said, I'll never fail you. You get ready to receive. You get ready to receive from God on a whole nother level, on a whole nother plateau. You get ready to see God's hand move upon your life mightily. No games, no gimmicks. Don't play. I decree that you're about to be compensated for everything that you lost. For every tear you cry, for every heartache, for every headache, you about to be compensated. And even somebody with some back issue, God is compensating you. He's healing your back. He He's healing your back. He's healing your back. You get ready to get compensated. When people walked away from you, God get ready to compensate you. But God bringing some people up to you that ain't going to leave you in tough time. God bringing some true prayer warriors up to you that's going to pray you through, that's going to help sustain you in your time of sustaining. God getting ready to compensate you for everything that you lost. Receive it in Jesus' name. 4 more minutes, family, and we gone. 3 more minutes. God is getting ready to compensate you for everything that you lost. And I need you to receive this under this anointing. This compensation is coming to you for everything that you lost. Prepare yourself, for there's going to be a visitation of God's spirit upon the land mightily. And people are getting ready to see why you didn't leave God, because God never left you. Receive it. You about to stumble into your blessing. You about to stumble into the biggest breakthrough of your life. Remain steadfast, unmovable, always abiding in the work of the Lord. God is about to compensate you. God is about to compensate you. God is about to compensate you. Receive it in Jesus' name. Everything I lost, give it back to me, though. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for the compensation. God, we thank you for the word today. We thank you for your presence. We thank you for your power. We thank you for demonstration of power, God. We thank you, God, for the fire. We thank you for the anointing. We thank you, Father, for being God and being God all by yourself. Father, we speak a covering over every person that the enemy tried to kill in an accident. Or that every person that the enemy got an accident with, we cover and we counsel the assignment of the enemy right now in the name of Jesus. And we plead the blood of Jesus over every person's car, over every person's house, over every person's family. We plead the blood of Jesus right now in the name of Jesus. Cover your people under your blood. Father, you said in your word, you'll never leave us or forsake us. You'll be with us to the end. Father, you showed us in the word today that you're getting ready to compensate us. You're getting ready to repay us for every heartache, for every tear, for every loneliness, for every letdown, every depression, every recession, every poverty. God, you're getting ready to repay us for health issues. God, you're getting ready to repay us, God. For people who walked away, you're getting ready to repay us for family members that let us down. You're getting ready to repay us for everything that was taken from us. And God, we tell you, thank you for repaying us, God. We thank you, God. We thank you, God. God, I decree and declare it over your people's life. Let testimonies come behind this life right now in the name of Jesus. And we speak it now. Into the four winds, from the north, south, east, and the west, let compensation come. Let our blessings run us down and overtake us. In Jesus' name, we decree and declare it done. In Jesus' name, and we counsel out the spirit of death concerning your people right now in the name of Jesus. They shall live and not die and declare the works of the Lord. And God, for every prophet that's standing in the gap, for every true prophet, true apostle, true fivefold ministry leader, true men and women of God, God, we speak a hedge of protection over their life right now in the name of Jesus. Right now in the name of Jesus. Father, you said in your word, let God arise and our enemies be scattered. Father, arise and let our enemies be scattered. We thank you for the compensation. We thank you for the word. We thank you for the miracle signs and wonders. We thank you for divine revelation. Father, we decree and declare it done in your son Jesus' name. in your son Jesus' name. In your son Jesus' name. Now, whatever you need God to compensate you for, if it's your finances, if it's a house, if it's a car, if it's a relationship, my God, if it's your health, it's your wealth, whatever you need God to compensate you, if it's your joy, if it's your purpose, I need you to put God, my God, don't put nothing but what you need God to compensate you for. For an example, if you need God to compensate you for a house, just put a house. Just put a car. Just put whatever it is. Right now, we sealing it under the blood of Jesus. Go. Put it. Put it. And angels are being dispatched on assignment. You getting ready to be compensated. You getting ready to be compensated. Come on. Come on. Come on. Help. Receive it in Jesus' name. Come on. Come on. Receive your health in Jesus' name. Come on. Whatever it is, put it. Finances, car, house. Receive it in Jesus' name. Come on. Car, receive it in Jesus' name. Finances, receive it in Jesus' name. House, job, receive it in Jesus' name. Come on, the fire burning. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Finances, receive it. Finances in house, receive it. Receive your financial healing, your financial compensation, your financial in your house, your finances, right now in the name of Jesus. Compensation, receive your finance, your job, receive your finances, right now in the name of Jesus. Your health, receive it. Financial miracles now in Jesus' name. Come on. My job, receive it now. House, receive it. Receive a house. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on. Healing, receive it. Total healing in Jesus' name. House, finances, car, receive it in Jesus' name. Finances, receive it in Jesus' name. Healing in Jesus' name. Finances, happiness, joy, stability, prosperity, great health, joy. Receive it in Jesus' name. Receive it in Jesus' name. Receive it in Jesus' name. Help. Receive it in Jesus' name. Listen, receive it in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Total healing in Jesus' name. Healing. Finance, car, job, house, spiritual walk, health, prosperity. Receive it in Jesus' name. Happiness and stability. Receive it in Jesus' name. New tires, windshield. Receive it in Jesus' name. Happiness, love, family. Receive it in Jesus' name. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Every blessing be released unto you. As you begin to receive, always remember, don't love the blessing more than the blesser. Receive growth in Jesus' name. Wisdom in Jesus' name. Happiness and joy and love in Jesus' name. Have peace, understanding in Jesus' name. This is your portion in Jesus' name. There is nothing too hard for God. Listen, we cover you under the blood of Jesus. And in the following days, as you begin to receive this from God, always reverence God, your peace in Jesus' name. Always give honor and glory to God. Don't love the blessings more than you love the blesser. This is only the beginning. Wisdom and joy and understanding. Peace, love, and happiness. heal it for your family, for your friends, in Jesus' name. Listen, family, was this morning helpful? 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 My relationship with God to be stronger. Was this morning helpful? Was this morning helpful? Hallelujah. Jalisha Tut, I see the Lord is getting ready to tug on you and pull on you, and there's going to be a desire for God like never before. They come upon you. There's going to be a desire. You're going to change many around you because of the walk that you will have with God. Get back and get into your word. Stay in your word. God is getting ready to move you higher. Higher. Hallelujah. Family, show some love and we're getting ready to go. Show some love, family. Show some love, family. Hallelujah. Listen, I always share the live where we can reach each, you know. If you get me to the people, the message itself, by me letting God use me, it'll reach them. Hallelujah. Make sure you share the word. Share the word. Because somebody need to hear the word. Somebody need to hear the word of the Lord. And it's up to you. Hallelujah. 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 God is getting ready to bless you. God is getting ready to compensate you. Hallelujah. Remember, remain steadfast, unmovable, always abiding in the work of the Lord. God is getting ready. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Sheena, we praying for you. It's a fight on your hand, but Sheena, we praying for you. We praying for you. We praying for you. Please, ma'am. Please, ma'am. Get back in church. Get back to read. Get back to seeking him. Stay in God. Don't go nowhere. Please. Please. Hallelujah, family. Listen, God bless each and every one of you. I love you. Hallelujah. I'm praying with you. And I'm praying for you. God bless you. We love you. Hallelujah. Shalom. Glory God. This is my day. Hallelujah. Jesus. This is my day. Hallelujah. Your very word spoken to me. And I hallelujah. And I we praying for you, Sheena. Love you. love you too. Hallelujah. Everybody keep Sheena covered. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God bless you, Miss Crenshaw. Hallelujah. We love each and every one of you. God bless you. We love you. Shalom. Smoking.